Close to 4 million TikTok videos removed by the social media giant, and that's only in the third quarter of last year. Jackie Pascual tells us how these videos violated the platform's community guidelines. Take a look.
Social media platform TikTok says it has removed 3.8 million videos in the Philippines alone as of the third quarter of 2023. These are videos that have violated the platform's community guidelines, which cover illegal activities, harassment, violence, self-harm, among others.
Online safety is always a shared responsibility. So on the part of the platform, our responsibility is to take down violative pieces of content at the soonest possible time. At the same time, we encourage our users, if they see some violative pieces of content still on the platform, please report them.
Most of the deleted videos were removed right after they were posted. Rada explains they have 40,000 content moderation team members who regularly monitor posts of users worldwide. Content creator Mona Magnovelus, known in TikTok as Mighty Magulang, encourages fellow content creators to post quality and positive content online. She is the only Filipino in the TikTok Safety Advisory Council, and she shares there is a need to constantly monitor social media sites.
Safety is an issue, and in our experience, there of course is disinformation, misinformation. There are also dangers that can transcend the digital space and affect us in real life.
Both Rada and Magnovelus believe parents should play a role in the safe usage of social media for their kids. TikTok, for example, has a parent pairing feature.
They would have some sort of control over the types of content, so that, say, harmful hashtags or inappropriate content for their age is not shown to teens and minors. But at the same time, you also recognize the other side of the coin, wherein you cannot just restrict content. You also have to properly have that conversation with your teens, with your minor children.
If you have smaller children, then don't give them too much screen time. If you have older children, have conversations with them so that their experience online will be positive and you are able to guide them.
Many other social media sites like Meta and YouTube have also beefed up safety features to protect children as online videos become increasingly accessible to all. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office reiterates their operations are above board after a Philippine Senate panel asks cybercrime investigators to examine the technology it uses to pick the winners. The probe was ordered after several multi-million jackpot prizes were won in just 1 month, but the head of PCO asserts there's nothing unusual with that.
It's a game of chance. I wish I could answer it. Bakit nanalo yung ganyang sunod-sunod? I really wish I could answer that. Meron po mga bagay that is really, as sinabi nga, game of chance. It just have to happen. Ito po is beyond reproach, itong proseso na to. And we have these issued invitations to the senators. Come and see for yourself bago sana mag-draw up ng conclusion. So again, we welcome lahat ng inquiry.
Opo.
Tama po yan kasi trabaho nila yan. I don't take it against them. That is their job. Mind you, PCSO was never envisioned to become a revenue-generating agency. It is meant to do a charity work.
And for those who believe in the mathematics of chance and possibility, based on mathematician Guido David's estimates, there is a 1 in 5 million chance to win PCSO's 642 game, 1 in 14 million for the 649 game, and 1 in 29 million for the 655 game. The question is, are you the lucky one? Tax expert Yuni Mata Reyes says more work needs to be done to improve the Philippine tax system. While Mata Reyes lauded efforts to boost tax competitiveness in the country, she stressed the need for additional enhancements to attract foreign investors and improve tax compliance. Her assessment comes after the Philippines' new finance chief, Ralph Recto, revealed his leadership's tax game plan. Recto had said the DOF would prioritize improving tax collection over implementing new taxes this year as his office reviews and refines tax proposals of his predecessor, Benjamin Jokno.
There were achievements here, to be fair.
like when they create lowered the corporate income tax from 30, you know, 25%, and it could even be 20. But I believe that there is still much to be desired. What they will look at is efficiency in the tax system, the cost of tax compliance, for instance, is the corruption, okay? And what they always don't like, what the investors don't like are changing the rules in the middle of the game.
Yeah.
Because when they come in, they will, it's cost, you know, it's cost benefit, cost expense revenue thing for these people. Mm-hmm. They would have already come in with a particular model or margin in mind, and when the taxes change, then suddenly everything is, it's upset.
Ride-hailing firm InDrive suspends its operations amid issues on its fare system. The move is in compliance with a suspension order slapped by the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board this Tuesday. The company has received complaints over its policy that allows its drivers to haggle fare prices. InDrive says it will further develop its application while suspended to ensure regulatory compliance. It also vows to make its services more fair, transparent, and accessible to provide better transportation alternatives to the public. The California-based company entered the Philippine market late last year. It has been touted as the potential competitor of ride-hailing giant Grab Philippines. Here's some unlucky news. Heads up for motorists. Fuel price hikes loom next week. Gasoline could see an increase of as much as 2 pesos 10 centavos per liter. Diesel anywhere between 65 and 85 centavos per liter. While kerosene could see a 30 centavo bump up. The Energy Department gave these estimates on the back of falling U.S. inventories, an expected rise in demand from China, where the central bank just vowed more stimulus, and strong demand from India. A group of business leaders backing the Marcos administration's new brand of governance known as the Bagong Pilipinas or New Philippines. The Buklod Bayani Coalition, composed of Filipino businessmen, civic leaders, and employers, inked an agreement with newly appointed economic czar Frederick Go on Wednesday. The deal covers the commitment of the business sector to help the government make the Philippines a destination of choice for investors by simplifying investment processes. Marcos last year launched the Bagong Pilipinas campaign with a goal of shoring up the economy and create more jobs and opportunities for Filipinos.